My Darshan of Bhagavan by Bart Walton. In his new book, American Pilgrim, An Ancient Quest in Modern Times, author Bart Walton describes his first visit to Sri Ramanashramam, where he experienced Bhagavan's ever-present grace. The Sanskrit word Darshan literally means a glimpse or sighting and refers to an auspicious meeting with a deity or enlightened sage. The term also suggests a blessing or spiritual energy that is transmitted during such an encounter. My darshan of Ramana occurred in 1994 during my third trip to India. How strange it must sound to hear me tell about having darshan of a saint who died before I was born. And yet, for anyone who has spent time at Sri Ramanashramam in South India, such a statement is perfectly understandable. Having previously visited the northern and western states of India, my wife and I decided to head south to explore Tamil Nadu. Several friends urged us to visit Sri Ramanashramam. At that time, I knew very little about Ramana Maharshi, and I did not really believe all the stories about the spiritual power of Arunachala Hill, nor did I see much value in visiting the ashram of a saint who had died some 40 years earlier. But my friends were insistent, so we decided to include Sri Ramanashramam on our itinerary. On the way to the ashram, I became seriously ill, and by the time we arrived, I was weak and had a painful cough. As soon as we got to our room, I just wanted to lie down, but for some reason, I decided to go with my wife to the Samadhi Shrine and Meditation Hall. When we sat down in the Meditation Hall, I leaned up against the wall and closed my eyes, hoping to get some rest. After a few minutes, I became aware of a light in my face. I opened my eyes, but the room was only dimly lit. Again, I closed my eyes and the sensation reappeared. After this continued several times, I left my eyes slightly open, hoping to catch a glimpse of what was going on. This time, I saw a brightness in my peripheral vision, as if the light were behind me. I looked overhead and out the window behind me, trying to figure out what was going on. This went on for about 10 minutes, playing cat and mouse with a strange light that crept over me whenever I relaxed my attention, and apparently no one else was aware of it. I thought to myself, "You've got a fever. You were hallucinating." So I walked back to my room and collapsed on the cot. I lay there facing a large photograph of Sri Ramana on the wall. He was looking down at me with his head tilted slightly and a beautiful smile on his face. Soon, the sensation of brightness came over me again. By now, I was too exhausted to figure it out, so I just accepted it and let go. Then suddenly, I realized that the light was coming from inside of me. I was flooded with peace and the strong sense of receiving Sri Ramana's darshan. When I opened my eyes again, there was Sri Ramana looking down at me from the picture. Unexpectedly, the question arose, "When I die, how will I find you?" I realized What an odd question this was, one that had never occurred to me before. Yet, for some reason, it arose with great urgency, as if it were the only question in life. Then I heard a voice ask in return, "How did you find me now?" In that moment, the significance of this exchange appeared in my mind as a clear insight. I could see that love is like a beam of light that connects us all to the spiritual higher dimensions. And this connection is always available beyond the apparent cycles of life and death. During the following days, I had nagging doubts about this experience, thinking perhaps it was just a delusion triggered by the fever. But during my stay at the ashram, I heard several people relay similar accounts, some even more dramatic than my own. Since then, I have read stories about Sri Ramana appearing in people's dreams even before they knew who he was. Only sometime later, they would see Sri Ramana's picture and realized that it was he who had appeared in that dream. It is a common lament among spiritual seekers that I was born too late. All the great masters have come and gone. If only I had been able to have darshan of Sri Ramana Maharishi. How often I have whined to myself like this. But after having this experience at Sri Ramanashramam, I now see the mistake in this way of thinking. As fantastic as it sounds, I believe it is never too late to have Bhagavan's darshan. He is still very much alive and active on the inner planes.